morning, Prof. I am Prakash Apte. I have been in IIT from 2001, teaching this subject to the undergraduates. Before that, I was in Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, doing experimental research in the integrated circuit fabrication and design. So I was there for 31 years, and some day I thought that now enough. I like to teach, so I came here. So happily, I have stopped doing research, but now I am doing research in teaching. So can't help it. So I have to find out why the education system has grown the way it has. So now I know. Tell me, I forget. This is called the lecture. So give a lecture, student will forget. Show me, I remember. That means you have to show, give demonstration, show tutorial, solve simple problems. So they remember. Involve me, I understand. That is why there are laboratories. So without laboratories, they will only remember Professor Apte taught well or he did not teach well, and that is all about it. After 2 years, he can't remember anything. So in today's lecture, I am going to tell you two jokes. After some time, you will remember the two jokes, because I am not going to teach you anything. So I am not giving you a lecture, nor I am going to give you a demo. I am just going to get involvement from you, because I think most of you have more experience than me on teaching. The second part of the teaching is that if I teach only one student, that is called a tuition. So I know exactly what his capabilities are, and then I actually fine tune, keep on varying till he understands. If there are 5-6 students or a little more, then it is called coaching. Even though there are a larger than number one, I still from time to time know everybody's name, and I know everybody's weak points and plus points, and I still fill it up. If I teach a class of 60, which you may be having, it is called lectures, that is called lecturing. And if you teach a class of 400 or 1000, that is called a address the audience. So the last one I know. We have to prepare a perfect thing with no flaws in it. I must rehearse it properly, so that exactly in 1 hour and 25 minutes I will finish it. It is like acting. You come on the stage on the cue and you start acting. So giving a lecture to 400 plus people is like acting. You have to perfect that art of acting, because nobody is able to interact. So this one is not acting, this one is not lecture, because there are not 60 of you, there are only 30 of you. So this is probably in between the coaching and the lecturing. So I am not going to take you or teach you anything, nor I will lecture. You are going to take a journey with me from what I call inverter to VLSI. So this digital lecture, therefore, it is inverter to VLSI. If it is some other lecture like analog, then I will say RLC to LSI. If it is some other lecture called design of experiment, then I will say design of experiments to industrial optimization. So I have got such 6 topics meant for an introduction to people who already are in field. It is not the undergraduate students. Already in the field, give them a quick overview, take them on a journey right from the first thing to the end thing. And I hope that if you like it, I can make all these things available to you. And the first lecture in digital electronics should be this one. So you also need to take the students on a journey to tell them in the first lecture how much of this goes all the way. And everything is not taught, there is no teaching in this. But since I am going to use the slides which I prepared, and you will of course see great familiarity with that, so I am not going to pause too much, then we will complete the journey. So I want to begin with the first light-hearted thing. I don't want any serious faces. Before me and after me, there will be people who will give you serious teaching. They are in the business of teaching. I was not in the business of teaching. So there is this corporate new corporate world called IT. When I went to Pune on a sabbatical, I found that there are all these young people, 30 years after 6, 7, 8 years of their inducting into the IT, they become managers, and then they have to have their principals are sitting in US, so they have to make a conference call at 8 a.m. before those guys go home, and then they have to wait till they come back next day at 8 a.m. That means this guy is there for 12 hours or more, because the Americans who give the money, they want to ask what did you do whole day. So they wake up and then they want to know what was done in the previous day. So these guys are working 8 to 8 and then they get so tired and they earn lots of money in return, but they all become very lethargic, their face bloats up and permanently you feel that they are lack of sleep, and there is a general feeling that weight is growing at the wrong points. And you know, there is a tiredness, and then they say that some of these guys are, you know, physically fit, something has to be done. So what I found, I was also in one of those glass buildings, by the way. So smart guy, ABS gymnasium was opened on the 8th floor, the terrace floor of that. You know, these guys know where to go. They want to go where the money is and poor health is. So 22,000 rupee fees for using gymnasium. They said, yeah, yeah, what's money, you know, where to try. So all these four guys got registered there, and there is a interactive training session, what they call, just for 3 hours. Afterward, the 22,000 is gone. So the training session was there. They just show them what you to do, and you know, start with a 1 kg weight, dumbbells and all that, and then slowly increase. So after that, these guys try very hard to, you know, put on half pants and towels, and you know, whole journey to 8th floor, do something and come back. And initially they say, yeah, yeah, this is working out very well. But after 1 month, the pressures come so much that they can't do anything. Every day there is another excuse for, you know, missing it. After 3 months they meet and then they not working. 66,000 chala gaya. Okay, what to be done? Don't know. Somebody says there is a personal trainers who come at home, and every day they will take exercise from you. So every day, but you know, home we have got none of these instruments, you know, weight training. So no, no, the yoga teachers, they're the best. So they all hire some services of yoga personal teacher, and then he starts coming, and the wife and the father benefit from that yoga teacher more than this fellow, because this fellow on some day is in a hurry. He says, sir, आज हमको थोड़ा टाइम नहीं है, हमको नया नया आसन दिखा दीजिए. So the yoga fellow is showing them new आसन. Some other day say, आज टाइम नहीं, आज तुम ही करो. So the yoga teacher does the exercise. And after 3 months they again meet, and again the same story. The fellow comes at home and everybody in the home is benefiting, but not this fellow. But one fellow is bright and shiny, you know, fresh looking. He says, अरे, who is your trainer? My trainer, the way fellow. Oh, we must take him, you know. You have improved. He said, oh, that fellow, useless. First week I fired him. You know, I had to do it myself for 3 months. So that's the story of any teaching. You do whatever you want. Kitna bhi monkey tricks karo, jump up and down. So that student understand, ultimately they have to do it for 3 months. That's the semester. At the end of semester they say, "Arey, teacher was bad, you know, finally I studied and I got marks." So that's, I think, good enough. So our job is to not allow them to forget. You show them from time to time some interesting problems, and then their attention is taken. So let's begin the journey. At the end of the time, you have another one coming, even more you can identify with it even more than this one. So we begin with this basic gates. So I belong to the previous generation, right transparencies and overhead projection and all that. Because I made a professor Dattara in IIT Delhi. I was so impressed with his presentation, beautifully written. So I only make a poor copy of his transparency making skills, but I try. So binary system of numbers is used to denote only 0, 1, what we call true, false. And I prefer to have this square looking rectangular 0 and this 1, sometimes I use with double line to differentiate between a normal 0 and 1 of the decimal system. So the number system, you know, all began with everyday use and use of 10 fingers to count, and then they derived that, and then there is a placeholder. So placeholder is, this is the placeholder for 1, then 10 and 100, and the meaning of 234 therefore is 2 into placeholder, 3 into placeholder and all that, and then you get 234, but now we already know this. Not that we need too much about the decimal system, but decimal system also have got placeholder which goes negative, and therefore beyond decimal we can also show that this is point. So we use the same strategy. Because after all, what is the difference? So now we have two interesting properties. The multiplication by the base 10 itself, you multiply, what happens is it shifts left. You add the lowest denominator, that is the 0. In that number system, 0 is the smallest. So it is called a null value. So multiplication like that, and division is by shifting it right. So I think multiplication by 10 and division by 10 is the easiest, only addition subtraction is more difficult. So binary system, we have a base of 2, we have got only 2 symbols, 0 and 1. So we have got these placeholders 1, 2, 4, 8, etcetera, and the meaning is the same, this 8 plus 2 plus 1, 11. But you have to write this 11 with a number system 10. Same way, 1011 in bracket, we have to write with number system 2. And then there is another number system, hex and hexadecimal and octal and so on. Of course, we teach the student how to convert decimal to binary and binary to decimal. So we go forward. So by analogy, multiplication by base 2 should be the same feature, shift left. Divide by base 2 should be shift right. So therefore, the toughest task is going to be the addition and subtraction, because as you know, in decimal you have to worry about the carry, you have to carry it forward, and therefore some way down the line I will give that. There are 3-4 versions of representation of the Boolean logic or the binary system, and we will see these 3 versions, and they are all identical. Implication of that is identical. One is a truth table, other one is a Boolean algebra, and third one is a logic symbol. Everything denotes exactly the same thing. One is graphical, the symbol. Mathematics, the symbol used will be false or true, or in short A for T. This is generally referred to as the Boolean logic. So Professor Bull, who gave all this, is in his honor, Boolean logic. So one of the easiest cases of Boolean logic is like that. There is a word statement, king ordered, behead anyone who has counterfeit coin. So now we have to invent a variable and assign some values and then show it like a Boolean equation. Another one is inspector takes statement from 3 witnesses A, B, C, and then A says B is lying but C is truth, B says A is lying but C is and if C is lying, C says B is telling truth but A is lying. Then we have to find out who is lying or who is true. So actually I know for sure that all the CID inspectors are supposed to take a course in digital, in logic. It is not digital, it is called logic. It is true that both A and B are lying. So A denotes speaking the truth and A bar. So we'll come to what this bar means. Bar is the opposite of this. So in a binary system it is just there or not there. So A is speaking the truth, then exactly opposite of that in English is lying. The B denotes similarly speak the truth, B bar denotes lying. And let the conclusion be denoted by C. So C denotes true, C bar denotes false, and then we can write a Boolean equation. So how do you read this equation? This statement is true if A is lying and B is lying. That is the way you have to read it. You should not read C equal to A bar and B bar, because it is not the 0-1 logic that we will do henceforth. This is a statement in English. So you have to read like that. And similarly, there is another one, if there is a OR function, we should not say A bar plus B bar. You have to say A is lying or B is lying. Now we come to the truth table. So truth table is for that function. So how do you construct the truth table? Since A is a Boolean or a binary variable, it has got two values, B is having two values. So we have got all combinations of A and B as 4. So we make, before we do anything, the left hand side can always be made. No, don't worry about that. If I got two variables, I can construct this, all 4 combinations. True, 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 false, false, true, false, false, all 4 combinations. If there were 3 variables, I would construct 8 combinations. If there are 4 variables, I will construct 16 combinations. And then I apply this to this. They say A is true and this is true. But since A is true, this would have become 0 because of that function. Therefore, we say false, false. Only both are false, this is true. That is what that statement is. So usually the function C gets this arrow here. The arrow will be here. This single line actually is good enough for denoting that function. We can also write now, if A, B are digital variables, then we will say 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, and then we say 0, 0 and this 1. C is 1 if we apply that equation and we actually evaluate it 4 times. So now we also know that now with the variables, we can now have a function. A certain statement is true only if, or if and only if, both A and B are true. Then this is called AND logic. The Boolean function is, the conclusion C is that both A and B are true, C is also true. Short form is A dot B, but should be read as A and B, but we take shortcut. So it is A dot B or simply AB, because our convention is that AB is already indicative of product, unless we say plus AB is a product. But dot is a much better one, and in logic it is better to always keep on saying A and B. Then we have got the same truth table. Obviously, only when both are 1, output is 1. The symbol is like this. This is a half hemisphere, or you can say half hemisphere with this side A and B, and the C is on the output. It is not bidirectional, it is a unidirectional. So actually one should say arrow inside going that way. So why do we have always write AB on the left hand side and C on the right hand side? If the same is written in a book in Arabic languages, the students will get confused that C is the input and it is splitting into A and B, because they read from right to left. So just because of that, just because a student is like a baby. The baby first, very great difficulty in the 9th month or whatever, barely able to stand and falls immediately. So we wish that it will perfect that position called standing. But before it perfects that position, it starts walking, again falls. then you say, oh, I wish he would walk perfectly. But without your realization, you now know that he is able to stand perfectly, but he is walking. And by the time you think that he will walk perfectly, he starts running. You say, oh, I wish he will be able to run. So my neighbor's daughter is already running at the age of 9.5 months. My son is not walking even at 11 months. So we get worried. But by then he is able to walk properly. So I think this is the way it is. They will not understand why it is written from left to right and so on. But while they learn, at some future time, when they make a microprocessor chart and all that, then inputs will come from top and left and right and everything. At that time, you would have already learned what is the meaning of a unidirectional logic. In the beginning, we should not do that mistake. Draw this vertically and all that, then they get confused, or draw it C on the left hand side, because they are still like baby learning. So this symbol automatically says that this goes from A and B goes to C, but C cannot split into A and B. This equation generally means the other way. So in I think C language, you know, they had some other symbol for it, not equating. In computer language, x is equal to x plus 5, what does it mean? It means something different, no? That x will now store a new value, the original x plus 5. So actually the arrow should be leftward, no? X plus 5 goes into it, but we do not. So we now, like babies, learn these idiosyncrasies with, you know, in our stride, left to right, unidirectional. Or logic, simply the statement that C is true if A is true or B is true, or both are true, does not matter. So we find that it is true for three of these. Therefore, the symbol is like that. There is a crescent like thing, and A and B goes to C. The symbol implies everything. It is absolutely perfectly defining the truth table, perfectly defining C is equal to A or B. All those three mean exactly the same thing, no difference at all. Then there is a thing of negation, not, do not do that. Children at the age of 12, 13, do not like that, do not do that. Like a child has climbed a tree, and you feel the child is too young to go to 15 feet height and a fall will break the leg. So you shout, hey, don't fall down, hold. That don't fall down is an instruction to him, because that fellow has never thought that he is going to fall down. Now he starts thinking that he will fall down, and in panic he will fall down. So when something is important, you don't begin with a negation. Don't do that. Instead of, you should say what they should do. Don't watch TV. You should say you should study now, or you should eat now, or you should go out and play now. Don't do that, then they will do that. But don't do that means they will do only that. So this is not A, but it is a inversion. Simply we just convert it from 1 to 0 or 0 to 1. Truth table is this and symbol is this. And so unfortunately, this symbol will confuse a little bit later with the analog circuits, because an amplifier also is shown like that without the 0. What is that 0? 0 or this so called circular thing, it shows a negation. This is the convention. Still it is one way only. My output, if it become 1, the input does not become 0. Only if input is 0, output become 1, or if input is 1, output become 0. This is not bidirectional. Still, any electronics you see, if output can be changed by something else, the input does not change. So now we have got this NAND circuit, not AND. So you should say that C is not A and B, that whenever A and B is 1, it becomes 0, and whenever A and B is 0, it becomes 1. So we say bar. So bar indicates the not function. This dot on both sides indicate that it is not an English word, it is a logic operation. AND with two dots on two sides also implies a logic operation. The symbol for NAND and NOR are like that, and we can also verify the truth table. I think you should do a quick exercise with student to how to generate this, but for that we will have to learn the theorems of logic. XOR is a special thing, exclusive OR, I would not spend too much time. There are some people who are very fond of it, some people like me are not very fond of it, but if it can reduce the electronic circuitry, I will use it. So, in say full adder, half adder, it is useful, it can reduce my circuitry, that is fine. Because why I do not like it, because I am not worried about, once I understand the basics, whether you give me 3 inputs and 2 of these are AND and 1 of these is OR, anything is okay. As long as I know that I have got this function, I got a truth table and I got a symbol, all imply the same thing. As long as I am sure of that, then do not worry. As I said, I must know the Boolean algebra before I can actually substitute in that Boolean function to fill up the truth table, otherwise I cannot logically fill up the truth table. So, basic theorems to define addition, subtraction, multiplication in the Boolean algebra is, I would not do anything great here, makes common sense once you know it, first time it is magic, this is the magic. A baby is not going to understand why it should not put its hand in on fire. You keep on telling, you know, bow, bow, something will happen. First time it has to happen, otherwise kid will not know. So, y is equal to a plus 1 is equal to 1. Now, you cannot understand this. You have not learned any mathematics which says anything like that. But this 1 is the confusing thing. If you go back to the symbol, true plus true, true. Two statements are true, the sum also remains true. So, true plus true is more understandable. A plus 1 equal to 1 is not understandable, because A can be either 0 or 1. When it is 0, it is okay, but when it is 1 plus 1 should become 2, but 2 in binary becomes 0 with 1 carry. So, there is a lot of confusion. So, this is like a rule and it has to be followed. Hopefully, students will understand by the time they go to third year. First year, follow the rule. A plus 0 is 0, understandable. A into 1 is A, understandable. A into 0 is 0. All these 3 are understandable except this. But this you have to push down their throat, you know, just take it. The rule 2, this false also, you have to now go forward, and similar 4 things. A dot A bar is the most important thing, this is 0, one of them has got to be 0. A plus A bar is always 1, because one of them has got to be 1 and anything added to 1 is 1. A true true remains true, A plus A 2 plus 2 remains true, but I think the most interesting thing is this, A plus A bar is 0. Then there are distributive laws and all that, you can actually create brackets, take things out of it, or if it is given like that, you can go out. This is both ways, this equation can be used both ways, this is not unidirectional, this also can be done, this also can be done. So, at absorption, so you absorb a term, so here it looks like A and B is same, so A and B, then C plus C bar. I am allowed to do that bracketing, but C plus A bar is always 1, one of them has to be 1, so I get A B, this is called C is absorbed. Also A B plus A is equal to A, so you can actually take A out, then it becomes B plus 1 in the bracket, which becomes 1. Now, you can beat anybody with the De Morgan's theorem till they say, sorry sir, I have not understood. You explain 3 times, but they will understand only when they have to work it out. So, simply if you just do this convert to this or this convert to that, that does not tell what is the theorem. Just makes a statement that these 2 things are equal, and then there is an algorithm for doing that. What is the algorithm? if I am given this A bar or B bar and totally not of that, then the algorithm is simple. If as soon as I have got this bar, whatever is the function inside the bracket, the algorithm is take a complement of a individual variable and also take a complement of the AND and OR function, that is the algorithm. So, here I have to do A, I have to take, B I have to take, and this complemented it becomes dot. So, OR becomes AND. So, this is the way it goes, A dot B. If you have this, then you have to take complement of this as A, complement of this as B, and dot function becomes OR function. This is the algorithm. Now, nobody reads the books. Does any student read a book? He will want to take a notes from you, and in the notes I am not going to write this. Which professor is going to write all this one paragraph of text that this is the algorithm, take every variable complement and convert every other operator by its complement. So, we neither put it in the notes nor student read the books, they do it only mechanically without understanding. So, that is why the teacher is required. All said and done, the teacher is required for speaking this out. So, you have to speak that out, because you do not have time to write it anyway. So, this is simple. What is the implementation? If I now take as an example, sorry if it is too small for people to see, A bar B bar and A B bar bar double bar. And then you can now say I can implement it in this way. This is a NAND function, NAND gate, this is a NAND function, NAND gate, then it is ANDed, and this is OR. That means this becomes another NAND, and I am able to now have this function written in this form implemented by logic. But I can expand this also, I can expand this out. The expansion has to be done by that algorithm. So, the expansion needs the algorithm. This is already a concise form which is suitable for logic implementation. Now, I am going to work out two things. How does anybody found the function from a truth table? Nothing else is given, only truth table, fully filled up by truth table is given. So, we now know all these ones imply a term in the my function. My function y has got these terms. So, this term is A bar B bar C, this term is A bar B C bar, etcetera. So, I have got exactly three terms, and exactly three terms should appear in my function y. That is the meaning. This is the way a truth table, fully given truth table, can be converted to a Boolean function. Exactly other way, if I have the courage to write this function, just small part of it I will write. This is y, and then I can also create a y bar. So, let us take only the first two readings. So, same logic I can apply, and I will say if I have got a fully filled up table for y bar also, then I can say y bar is equal to the number of ones there. So, now which one should I choose for implementation, y or y bar? Y has got 3 terms and 5 zeros. So, I will get a function of 3 entries, but y bar will get a function of 5 entries and will require more hardware. But sometimes there are more ones and less zeros, in which case we should do y bar. So, student should be taught to immediately convert this, add another table mechanically, just flipping this and see which one has got fewer terms. Therefore, we get the implementation. This is what I have done. Actually write A bar, B bar, C bar, etcetera, all these terms are written. So, 0 means A bar, 1 is B, C, like that you write, and then you fill up this thing. This is ultimately, after such an exercise, you can tell the student that this means the sum of products. This looks like sum of products. These are products and a sum of them. So, sum of products, y only pick up the entries which are 1, and a product of sums pick up all entries of y bar as a dual. This is the dual, means exactly opposite applies. So, we normally do not worry about the duals that much. A logic problem can be worded like this. As an example, there is a Jones, the farmer. So, the problem is the Jones has got a dog, a goat and a cabbage, and there is a problem. The dog will go after the goat, chase it out. The goat will eat the cabbage, but dog will not eat the cabbage, and therefore, this is the thing. So, in our home, we are three people, myself, my mother and my wife. Just imagine the goat, dog, and so there is a problem there, and that problem is very similar to this one. So, in this case, we just stick to the dog and goat and cabbage. So, any one of them could be either on the north side or on the south side. And if Jones must always be with such a pair which is likely to fight. If Jones is there, when goat and cabbage is there, he will prevent that goat from eating. If Jones is there, when the dog and goat are together, then he can prevent the fight. But if Jones is in the south and goat and dog are in the north, then you had it, or vice versa, goat and cabbage in the other section, then you got a problem. So, you say that preferred combinations are like that. Send an alarm if Jones is in the wrong side with dog and goat. So, Jones is in one section, dog and goat are in the other section. Jones is now in the other section, but the goat and cabbage are in the other, in this section, and so on. So, we can read it like this. So, there are four possible bad combinations, and alarm bell has to ring. So, usually at home front, the husband has very good health, because he has to take long walks for long time, many times a week, and his health becomes good. So, Jones also, his health is very good, he has to run from north part of the farm to the south farm, should any trouble be there like this, because he has to be on the same side where these bad combinations exist. But now, having got this formulation done, now we want to implement this in a logic. The alarm has to be electrically operated alarm. And this dog being there and all that is because of something you have put on the dog and goat, and Jones himself has got a identifier to locate where he is. Now, we have to minimize that, because we want, what is the common factor. So, we need to minimize this function, because the electrical circuit will require too many gates. How many gates will it require? 4 3 input AND gates and 1 4 input OR gate will require. 3 input AND gate, 4 of them, and 1 4 input OR gate, and I think it is too many. So, nobody makes 4 input OR gates, then it will require smaller pieces of 2 input OR gates making up a 4 input OR gate. So, the whole exercise is that having got the original such function, either by arguing like this physical problem or getting such function from the truth table. The truth table can also give many terms. In the earlier example, we had 3 terms of 3 inputs. So, where is the 3 input NAND gate, OR gate, etcetera. So, that means, we have to make do with 2 input gates. Therefore, all these things need to be now minimized. But this was a very old strategy, and in the VLSI of today, where billions and billions of things in FPGA, this criteria is no more. But as a simple thing, we should now do this. So, Carnot created a graphical tool, which actually imbibe all those Boolean function rules and theorems without you knowing. So, this is like a graphical tool, without you knowing the absorption principle, it absorbs variables. I have got 3 input variables, 4 input variables or 4 variables, I must reduce it to 2 inputs. That means, I have to absorb some of these variables from those product terms. So, the whole idea is a table is created with say 2 variables, we say B bar B, A bar A like that, and we can go all the way to 4 variables. So let us take a arbitrary thing like this. So I got 4 terms coming out of that truth table, and now I want to minimize it. So you know what we have to do? We have to find the near neighbor and put a circle, and this poor fellow will not find anything. So I'll come back to this, but this is the Carnot map principle. This and this, when we combine, this 0 and this 1 get absorbed. That is the principle, that is the fundamental rule. So this is the absorption principle. So this variable B disappears, only C will remain, and therefore, and of course A will remain, A equal to 1. So like that you have to get 3 terms, but this poor fellow, this is a poor relation, has got no friend, and all 3 terms will remain. So now we have got hold of B bar C AC and A bar B bar C. So we reduce some logic, there were 4 3 input gates required and 1 OR gate with 4 inputs, now reduced to 2 2 input gates AND gates, 1 3 input AND gate and 1 OR gate with 3, but I am not happy. Can we reduce it further? Unfortunately, no, because these poor fellows decide that they will remain. The logic is like that, we cannot do anything. So student, we have to very clearly say that minimization does not mean that you will get what you want, everything in 2 inputs. Minimization has got a limit, depends on the function. If it cannot be minimized, it cannot be minimized, because otherwise the student forcibly push it to 2 inputs and of course get the wrong answer. Then they say that method is right, sir, give marks. So now this is the other one. Without going to detail, we can see the larger these groups we can make, the larger absorptions you get. A group of 2 absorbs 1 variable, group of 4 absorbs 2 variables, group of 8 will absorb 3 variables. So you do that, poor fellows are no more, because this can, this is like a, you know, closed cylinder on itself. The worst which I have not given is this 4 corners. Every student misses that out, because these 4 corners are also like a closed path, and therefore also can absorb variables. So well, let us leave it at that. Carnot map is a very, very good technique, interesting. Yes. Which one, which circle you are referring?
First circle, first 2 ones.
This one?
Sir, A bar.
No, you tell me which row you are talking about. Which row?
First row and the last row, sir.
First row and the?
Last row.
Last row.
Form a quad, sir.
Should you take? Anybody? We should take, not we can take. I was about to go there, but I wanted her to. Many times I ask a question feigning that I do not know. So many a student have told me that you have not yet completed. This is wrongly done, half done. Yeah. So this should be combined with this. So we have to see as many combinations to be done. What the student and I have done mistake is that once I see this is done, it gets out of my mind. And I do not reuse it. I reuse this because of this poor relation. I was forced to use it. But here I found a circle of 2 and I gave up. So this is the fallacy of not reusing the ones. And therefore I prefer, you must seriously make, since this is a variable 4, seriously see is there anything with 8. Then you should write. The student should write, not a single combination of 8 is with this Carnot map, he has to write. Then you see I see 1 and I see 2 in the Carnot map with 4 entries, like that you have to go down and finally say which is the poor relation, not finding any combination at all. Otherwise you have this mistake that once you have drawn the circle, then we forget about it. Perfectly right, madam. If these were representing like ABCD, if they were representing only a binary coded decimal, then we know that there are numbers beyond 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, which will never occur, because that is a display, binary coded display. And therefore, these are these 6 entries which will never occur. So we use them as optional, and now use these all stars also as optional and make groups of 8, as many groups of 8 as possible. And then you see here, I have no combination on the 4 corners, but I have now tried to make as many big ones, then the next ones and the next ones. Because a student is never sure, has he got the final answer. And I always tell the student that unless you get the final minimized answer, you will not get full marks. So, this is the method they have to write. I found 2 of these which are 8, then I found one only which is of 4, and then that is it. So, that is all I get, 2 with the 8 and 1 with 4, and this is absolutely minimum. Okay, I can check this. If I write on my answer book this statement, then there is easy to check. So, I think this is a good habit. As I said, in the modern context, these things are not required, unfortunately. So, I think with your permission, I will skip the half adder, full adder.